Hey friends, back with another episode of Strip Club Talk with Jade and Danny. Hello, Jade.
Hey, Danny.
We're getting some good reaction to the show. Do you notice that? All the comments and stuff. People leaving some fun comments on there. We've been doing this for a few weeks now, and we're just different things that go on in the strip clubs we've been talking about. And today, this is going to be an interesting one. We are going to talk about the challenges of having a relationship when you work in a strip club.
I mean, many challenges there are.
Yeah, I mean, it's different than if you're like in corporate America working for Procter & Gamble or something like that. You know, there's a lot more jealousy involved in the strip club industry because, you know, the girls are working naked and some guys don't like that. So we're going to talk about basically three different things today. We're going to talk about how you can date and the pros and cons of each one. The first one is to date outside the industry. Find somebody who doesn't work in there, and then you can kind of separate your personal life and your work life. But we'll talk about that and the pros and cons on that. We're going to talk about dating someone who comes in your club as a customer, I mean. And then we will talk about dating a coworker, and we'll talk about those pros and cons as well. So let's start with dating outside the industry. To me, I have no luck dating outside the industry. As soon as I tell somebody what I do for a living, you're a strip club DJ? Come on. No. You know, I mean, that's just right. Like, you know, swipe left. That guy's gone. what about you from the female standpoint, from an entertainer standpoint? Pros and cons of dating outside the industry. Tell me about some of your relationship stories.
So it's definitely been a struggle dating outside the industry because a couple of things can happen. You know, the person says that they understand, and honestly, in their mind, they probably believe that they do, and they don't think it would ever bother them. And then you get into a relationship, and next thing you know, they're like, well, you know, maybe you could look for a different job, you know, and then they're, you know, suddenly uninterested. And now this, obviously, we're not talking about this being like the guy who's a customer. This is just somebody you meet and they find out you dance.
Right.
That could happen. Or the person immediately just thinks like, oh, she's easy. Come dance for me. And then you get, you know, the person who just thinks that that's what you are all the time. Like they don't separate the two. They don't realize you're an actual regular human being as well. You know, so it's kind of a struggle. And I don't think, like you said, I don't think I've ever really found somebody who has been very understanding of the industry, unfortunately.
Have you ever dated somebody and not told them what you do right at first? And then all of a sudden it turns into something and you're like, oh, shit, I guess I got to tell them now.
Right. So it's never gotten that far. But I definitely, it is something that I actually never tell in the beginning. Obviously because I'm also a hairstylist, that kind of works out for me. So that I can just lead with that. And then eventually I'm like, oh, by the way, if you haven't noticed that I'm not your average, you know, girl with like my hair and makeup and just the way that I carry myself, you know, I also am a dancer. And then obviously, that kind of makes things change gears and they either kind of run or they stick around thinking that they can handle it. And then obviously whatever we've already talked about happens. Mm-hmm. So, but I don't think I've ever let it get to escalate to that point to where like, I guess I better tell them now it's getting pretty serious. So I can imagine that happening though. Like I'm sure there are people who've been in this situation.
Yeah. I think for DJs, it's like I say, I started to tell you a little bit about it earlier, but I think, you know, you tell somebody you're a strip club DJ, and this is relationships or anywhere. Tell your neighbor you're a strip club DJ. People that don't go to strip clubs have no clue what a strip club DJ does. Okay. They think he sits up there on the mic and goes, hey, okay, guys, look at the titties on that girl. Hey, everybody come up here, motorboater, you know, and all that stuff, you know. And they just think that it's, you know, the stereotype of a strip club DJ to the outside world is the guy that has his shirt's unbuttoned down to here. He's got all the gold chains and he's got, you know, the hoop earrings, which I used to have.
Right.
you know, coal black hair and just, you know, smelling like a bottle of Brut. Kind of like Ron Jeremy. So anyway, oh, he's in jail. He can't do anything. So anyway, that's kind of what it's always been for me. So it's real hard for me to date outside the industry. Also, you know, for me being older, I really need to one of these days grow up and realize that I am older and I need to start dating older people. But one quick story, I was dating somebody a couple years ago and she was in her mid 30s, which is half my age. And so, you know, the problem was, and she said, it's not that I don't trust you. It's not that I think you're sleeping with all of these young girls. My problem is that you work with a lot of 19, 20, and 21-year-old perfect bodies. I'm mid-30s. I don't have the perfect body. I wonder when I take my clothes off in front of you if you're comparing my body to those young little 18-year-old perfect bodies. And I hate to say it, she kind of, I understood what she said. And it didn't work out. I got dumped. But, you know, it's that's what the outside world looks like.
Mm-hmm.
So,
unfortunately.
Yeah. Second part. How about dating somebody who comes in the club? This is always a touchy one. They always tell you never date your customers. However, it happens. And sometimes it's not meant. You didn't mean for it to happen. But, you know, in this day and age, the social media and everything, you know, you don't have to give your phone number out anymore. You can just give your Instagram or whatever, and they start messaging you. And all of a sudden, one time, or maybe you're out with your friends someday, and they're out with their friends someday, and you run into each other out at a public gathering, and, you know, things start to happen. So have you ever dated a customer, somebody who came into the club?
So obviously, to give you a direct answer, yes, I think everybody has. It's something that I've always tried really hard not to do, just because I know it can get messy and it's not ideal. My thing that I always tell people is I'm a little old fashioned. I think that it's better to date first and then you see me with my clothes off versus seeing me with my clothes off and then we date. Mm-hmm. My only couple situations where I've dated somebody who technically would be a customer would be one time I dated a guy when I was really young, maybe around the age of like 17, 18, 19 years old. We didn't date very long. And then we reconnected because he actually came into the club as a customer.
Oh, okay.
And it was like, oh, wow, how have you been? You know, and then that's how that happened. And then the other occasion was actually somebody I had met at the club. And for me, that was messy enough to make me never want to do that again. So, and then, I mean, it never turned into the whole, like, I don't want you to dance anymore, which is very fortunate for me, in that situation, cause I didn't have to deal with that. But it was one of those, like, I try to tell people sometimes, like, when you're a pretty girl, a lot of times you end up dating, guys who are very, into a lot of pretty women. So you end up becoming, you know, one of numerous beautiful women that they encounter on a daily basis, wherever they go. Mm-hmm. And it just so happens they like to frequent clubs. They like to frequent bars where all the pretty girls go to. So that for me was enough to be like, okay, let's look elsewhere.
Mm-hmm. I think, and you've probably heard this many, many times in your times of working in the clubs, and I have too, where an entertainer will come up to you and says, I got to quit my job. And you say, why? Well, my boyfriend doesn't want me stripping anymore. Mm-hmm. Well, where did you meet your boyfriend? Well, I met him here at the club, but right. Okay. I'm just going to say this. Guys come into the club. They want to get laid, basically. So you started off having casual sex and just getting laid. And then all of a sudden, things started getting serious. And now you don't want anybody else to get laid by your girl. So you want to pull her out of the business, even though just because you went in there, your goal was to get in her pants. You didn't mean for it to turn into a relationship, but guess what? It did. But now you want to make sure nobody else gets in her pants. So you want her to quit. Mm-hmm. I mean,
like, what if it's somebody else is as smooth as me?
Yeah, I mean, and like you say, there are guys who go, you know, they'll see this girl, then they'll start seeing this girl, then they'll start seeing this girl. It's like, dude, you know, you've been with five girls who work here.
Yeah, I have had multiple friends run into that situation. Like, and then it's like, next thing you know, you don't see them. You don't see them for several weeks, couple months. And then depending on the situation, they either break up and they come back to work and you're like, oh, I know why she's back at work. Or she just kind of ghosts the club and you don't really see her again. I will say, not to call anybody out, but my only my only run into with that situation with someone not wanting me to dance anymore was in high school. My high school boyfriend, that's when I started dancing, was like right at the end of high school, and thought I could handle it. And then it turned into like a not very direct, you know, I don't want you to dance, but like, you know, starting arguments because I was going to work and it was Friday type thing. So like that is very unhealthy, I will say. It's got to be hard, like you said, you know, next thing you know, it's like sometimes that type of customer, that's a goal, obviously. And then they don't realize, oh, wait, I caught feelings.
Mm-hmm.
So
can't control those, man. They do what they want. Okay. The third topic, dating a coworker. You as entertainers, you're around floormen, you're around managers, you're around DJs, things like that. And you've been in the business long enough that you've seen this happen with people. Mm-hmm. So I first of all, give me your thoughts on dating a coworker. I know you shouldn't do it, but it's easy to do it because you've got a lot in common.
Mm-hmm. I mean, and that's honestly, you could say this for any industry, just because, you know, they say that most people are working more than they're home. You know, you're working 40 hours a week sometimes if you're obviously like you being a DJ or even like the floorman or the, you know, bouncers or what have you. You know, you're on a schedule. Like us dancers, yeah, it's easy for us to come and go on nights we want to work. But if you're working a lot, you're there a lot and you're there a lot together. You guys understand the industry together. You're working, you're, you know, gossiping when there's downtime and things like that. So I definitely can see how obviously you end up having a lot in common and then things can, it's a slippery slope. And the only thing I would say about that situation though, it can be kind of dangerous because, you know, I think it's very important to remain professional. And I think that some people have a very difficult time doing that. And I think that's where it becomes a little bit of an issue because, you know, next thing you know, say a bouncer and a dancer are dating and the floorman just can't handle now, whereas before he could and it wasn't a big deal, but now he can't handle seeing her giving lap dances to a guy or, you know, those kinds of things. What are your thoughts?
Obviously, I've dated inside the industry myself. I think that you really have to go into it. When you start, you have to go into it with a great understanding. The big thing is when we are in the club, you are your stage name and I am the DJ.
Exactly.
We are not in a relationship in this building because I have dated girls before where they want me to join in their feuds. We all know that there are certain girls who don't like other girls. And I remember a girl coming up to me and bitching at me because the girl who was on stage is somebody she didn't like, and I made a positive comment about her, or I ran some great lights for her. It's like, I can't believe you said that about that bitch, you know, or something like that. So, you know, the girl doesn't control the DJ doesn't control the girl.
Mm-hmm.
You have to go into it. And I'm not going to say don't date a coworker because I've done it.
Right.
And I think it's the easiest for us, but you have to have these ground rules. And the other really bad thing is you really need to talk about what happens if this doesn't work out. And you have to talk about this while it's working out. I mean, everybody wants to think the relationship they're in is the one that's going to last forever. Right. But let's face it, most of them don't. So you have to have an agreement that, hey, if this doesn't work out, you and I are going to still stay completely professional in this building. Outside the building, gloves are off, but inside the building. And I will tell you, one of the hardest things I ever did when I first broke into this industry, which was when I broke into the strip club industry, which was 95, 96, I was 42 years old. And what happened was I started giving a ride home to one of the entertainers. Well, the ride home comes to, are you hungry? Have you gotten something to eat? Mm-hmm. And then, oh, guess what's on TV tonight? And then that turns into a back rub, which turns into a relationship.
Right.
So, I mean, we had a great, about a year. She lived with me for about a year. And then we started having some issues. So she moved out, but we were still dating. And I remember finding out that she was sleeping with my other DJ. And then I found out that I was the only person in the club who didn't know that she and my other DJ were fucking. So, I mean, you know, here's my first thought. You know, the bosses had told us all, the bosses always tell you, listen, if you guys can't work, one or two of you are going to be gone. And I had to sit there and think, okay, I just lost a girl who I loved very dearly. I'm really pissed off. I want to take a baseball bat into the club and beat the crap out of this fucking DJ.
I bet.
But I said, okay, you've already lost your girl. Are you going to lose this good money job as well? So I had to really, really, really work hard. And she kept working my shifts, and I kept calling her the beautiful Miss, and I'm not going to use her name because she's still a friend of mine now. And she may watch this, so I don't want to.
Right. We don't want to do that.
Yeah. But, you know, that was one of the rougher things. So I think it is really, really important. And that's the thing that scares me when I see couples date that work together is you wonder, how is this going to work out? Is one of the two of these going to, am I going to lose, you know, one or two of these people, you
right.
know, if the
right.
breakup happens?
Yeah, exactly. And I like how you put that as far as you need to have that discussion on whether, you know, like what would happen if it doesn't work out, because you're exactly right. You know, obviously it is, if it turns into a mess, both people could leave, you know, and then there goes a really strong, possibly dancer, possibly DJ, you know, floorman, somebody who had a really good work ethic, you know, and that's just not a good situation. So it is important, I think, to definitely remain professional at all times, even if you do fall into a relationship and things are really good, you know, because, you know, even if things are really good at that moment, it's not good to go around, you know, flirting with each other on the floor, doing that sort of thing. Next thing you know, you've got like, you know, other dancers telling customers or customers noticing that, you know, and they're like, oh, is that your boyfriend? You know, and like, that's the last thing you need. It is your environment to make the most money you can possible. And it is not good to have that kind of interference.
I know a DJ and a dancer that dated. It was in a different club. But I went into, I knew them both real well. So I went in there and they had broke up. And I mean, I'd have fired a DJ for doing this myself, but this DJ started playing. Whenever she got on stage, he would play her, Use a Ho, She Loves My Cock, all the, you know, just
right.
Yeah. And you know, she stayed up there on stage and danced and smiled to it and then came off the stage. And then you'd see them both in the DJ booth arguing like crazy. Yeah. So, you know, you got to stay for, you know, I always look at relationships like this, you know, yeah, if it didn't work out, it didn't work out, but there was a reason you started it. You know, there has to be something good there. So just write it off as somebody I dated. It didn't work out. Now let's move on.
Exactly.
But so with those three things, we've kind of talked about the pros and the cons of dating. And obviously people are going to date. Hopefully we gave you some tips on how to make it work a little bit better. But I do want to say for me personally, I don't like to date people I work with. I just, I don't like to do it. I like to keep my mind clear and fresh when I'm in the DJ booth. So what I generally tend to be attracted to are entertainers who work other strip clubs. Right. That's my kind of girl right there. Or, you know, maybe a house mom who works another strip club or something like that. That's really what I get attracted to anyway, because, you know, that's you're safer there.
Yeah. They're still in the business. They're still in the industry, but you don't have to be one-on-one so close.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Wow. We had a good subject today.
We did.
Great subject today. Next week, I don't even know what we talked about. We're going to talk about next week.
I don't think we did.
Okay. Well, I think there's this pet peeve thing that you want to bring up to me. We'll do that next week.
We'll do that.
Which is, you asked me once before my biggest pet peeves on new entertainers, and I don't have any because, you know, they're new and they're, you know, I am very understanding. But I know you wanted to ask me about my pet peeves with established entertainers. And
yes.
Can we keep the show under 30 minutes?
We'll try.
We will try. Hey, follow both of our YouTube channels. We release these shows every Friday by 3 p.m. on both of our YouTube channels. Like, smash the bell, all that stuff that everybody, you know the drill by now. Leave comments, man. What do you think? Please. You know, do you agree with what we said? Do you disagree? And if you disagree, tell me you disagree. I mean, I don't care.
Yeah.
Tell me I'm stupid and I'm out in left field.
I would like to see what people would like to see us talk about as well.
Mm-hmm. And by the way, I am single. So if you're hot and you work in another strip club, you know, slide into my DMs. Jade, thank you so much. And you guys, we'll catch you on the next one.
We'll see ya.